morning, everyone. Did you ever good old neighbor Nicky can frozen to and all time to die fan to that one year. And welcome to the next amazing video and welcome back to another Halloween review week. We are almost done and on November 1st is a Disney movie week. So I really hope you get yourself ready for Disney movie week because it's going to be pretty fun. And honestly, I'm probably my first Disney movie review week I'm doing a movie review on The Great Mouse Detective because I have not talked about the movie in this channel. So you guys, I'm probably on November 1st. Probably my next movie review is my The Great Mouse Detective, but it will be November 1st. Anyway, now we're going to talk about this movie. Happy 1st anniversary to this movie because this movie turned 1 year old. So happy anniversary to this amazing creepy movie. So today, I'm doing a movie review on Last Night in Soho from the director who made Baby Driver, came out of year of 2021. So hey guys, I have not seen this movie in theaters because I was planning to go see this movie in theaters and I was saying to myself, you know what, I don't want to go see this movie in theaters. Honestly, it's not because the movie is look greatness, but honestly, don't get me wrong, this movie's great. But honestly, I'm just not a huge fan of watching horror movies in theaters because honestly, you know the reason why I'm not a huge fan watching horror movies and videos? Because some people like to scared, like the freaking scaredy cat, and kicking the seat while you're watching a movie. And honestly, I'm probably saying to yourself, Nick, is that a real thing? Yes. I've been watching the audience trailer about The Green Inferno, The Nun, and The Conjuring. All I see is that people get scared over movies. Come on now, even this movie's scary, but it's not really scary now, come on, man. And sorry, guys, so after I watched this movie online, like, last year, and I really enjoyed this film, but after the more I think about this movie, more I really love it even more. And this is honestly one of my favorite movies from the director who made Baby Driver, which honestly, his name is really complicated to talk about, but oh well. And sorry, guys, do I have any negative about this movie? No, I don't have any flaws about this movie. This movie is 100% perfect. And sorry, guys, when this movie came out, a lot of people was completely let down for this movie, which honestly, I don't understand why some people is completely let down for this movie. And sorry, guys, in this movie got some okay rating, and it got 76% on Rotten Tomatoes, and thank God I got a fresh rating. And for the audience, it got a 90%. Honestly, that's not bad. That's not bad. At least it's way better getting rotten. Jeez. And sorry, guys. Let's talk about how masterpiece this movie is. Let's talk about the story. The story is really original because this is the very first original story from the director who made Baby Driver. Because honestly, his directing style is always comedy. But this movie is completely different. This movie is not a comedy. This movie is like a horror movie. Yep, this movie is like a drama and horror movies at the same time. And sorry, guys. And the characters, I do remember every single character of the film. Elizabeth, she is a really likable character because I feel so bad for her that she was a fan of Anya Taylor-Joy character Cindy, and her nightmare get in her and she was acting so crazy and her friend said, and I feel so bad for her because she's really attractive in this movie, and Anya Taylor-Joy as Cindy. Oh my goodness, I really like that kind of Cindy right here because Anya Taylor-Joy, she did a fantastic job. And honestly, she was not trying to be the villain. And honestly, the main reason why she was being the villain is, sorry, I'm saturating again. Back on saying, sorry, guys. And the main reason why she was not a villain in this movie is because a lot of men treat her like crap. And Matt Smith's treating Anya Taylor-Joy characters like crap because honestly, I feel so bad for Anya Taylor-Joy in this movie. And Matt Smith, OMG, this is way better than he was in Morbius. Yeah, people, do you remember he was in Morbius? He was doing the stupid dancing, which honestly, that is absolutely stupid, and that is absolutely pointless. And so, yeah, honestly, Matt Smith, honestly, even I'm not a fan of Doctor Who, yeah, I think Doctor Who is overrated as crap, so I might do a mini rant on Doctor Who, because I'm not a huge fan of Doctor Who, so I don't care what everyone said. And sorry, guys, and let's get the black kid, which honestly, he is a really likable character, but he's sadly, honestly, he was almost killed off at the end of the film, but all the way at the end of the film, he came back to life. So honestly, it is just me, but honestly, it is just me, or he just looked like Miles Morales from Spider-Verse 2.0. Honestly, he is really like Miles Morales 2.0 because they both have different impressions. And the cinematography of the film, is what Oscar worthy. So I don't understand why this movie got snubbed in the nomination anyway. Anyway, guys, and the costume design looks absolutely brilliant. Like Anastasia Joy, Matt Smith, Lucifer, and the Black Kid. And honestly, the costume design looks absolutely amazing. And the climax of the film, this is the main reason why this movie got me some nightmare. Because at the end of the film, while the main characters was walking the doors and all the man's hand was grabbing her, and honestly, that is honestly one of the most creepiest and disturbing thing I ever seen in my entire life. But in a good way. But hey, at least I can watch this movie more than Saw 3D. Honestly, I cannot stand Saw 3D. Sorry, I keep mentioning that movie. Anyway, let's get back to this movie. And at the end of the film, why the main character walking to those moms and the Black Kid after they walk in the show, Anya Taylor-Joy blowing kisses, and boom, that's the end of the movie. Good job, Anya Taylor-Joy. Great job. I cannot wait to rewatch this movie again and again and again. So overall, guys, Last Night in Soho is an epic, brilliant masterpiece with the original story, amazing character, amazing performance, the cinematography work absolutely beautiful, and Downtown by Anya Taylor-Joy? Wow, Anya Taylor-Joy can sing her butt off. And sorry, guys, I don't understand why this movie got snubbed at the Oscars. And the biggest thing I have a problem with the Oscars is because this movie didn't get nominated for Best Costume Design. So are you telling me that Coming to America is a way better costume design than at Last Night in Soho? Have you lost your mind? Honestly, Coming to America costume design looked absolutely hideous and I cannot stand it. Sorry about that, guys. If you're a huge fan of Coming to America starring any movie, I can accept your opinion. But for me, I'm not a huge fan of that movie. I'm not a huge fan of the first movie. I am definitely not watching the sequel. Jeez. And sorry, guys, this movie is honestly one of my favorite horror movies of 2021. This movie is honestly one of my number 5 favorite movie of 2021. Because right now, my number 4 is West Side Story. And my number 3 is Encanto. Number 3 is Spider-Man No Way Home. And Encanto is in my number 2. And number 1 is No Time to Die. Yep, No Time to Die will always be my favorite movie of 2021. But right now, this movie is in my number 5 now. And so, yeah, guys, I am giving Last Night in Soho a 10 out of 10. This is an epic, brilliant masterpiece. And I am giving this a brilliant movie a seal of Nikic awesomeness. So, yeah, that was my movie review on Last Night in Soho. Tell me what you thought of this movie in the comments section below. Well, spoiler. And honestly, I know a lot of people was completely let down for the ending. But honestly, I am no mind with the ending because this is what horror movies were. Because they took our time to add a horror element because, honestly, most of the horror movie back in 2010, they always watch the horror theme anyway. Anyway, guys, if you like this video when your famous stuff turning into a nightmare, oh boy, please, I highly recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn on notification, and share your video for whole family. And my next Halloween video tomorrow is honestly one of my top 10 best and worst horror movies of all time in my... And on probably tonight, stay tuned for my rant on the Teen Titans Go Halloween special. I cannot wait to tear that Halloween special apart because it's the longest rant you're gonna wait for a long time. And November 1st, stay tuned for my movie review on The Great Mouse Detective because that review request by Preston. So Preston, your request will go first and then Frozen request. And so, hey guys, subscribe, comment, share this family. Tell me what you saw on this movie on the comments section below. So, all you like meme and you really love this movie, all you like the fan base that you did not like this movie, you think this movie's terrible, comment below and let me know. Stay tuned for my next rant on the Teen Titans Go Halloween special. I almost say holiday special, but oh well. And so, hey guys, I see you next time. And so, one can peach you too. Have a great morning, everyone. And I see you and stay tuned for my next video next time. And I see you guys. I see you guys later.
least I can do is drive you home.
Ah, what's the most?
Well.
Do you know Goose Street?
Very well.
I'm on Goose Place, number 8.